Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are gonna see the tutorial about the Takuchi method. At first, let's see why did we select this method. The main reason is that it's a straightforward, and also this design method is greatly used in the manufacturing field because of its contribution to reduce the number of experiments. Besides, the Takuchi method assumes that the model will have only the main effect terms and there will be no cross product effects, which means we don't consider any interaction effect in the Takuchi method. If you see in a detail, effect of independent variable 1 on performance parameter does not depend on the different level settings of any other independent variables, which means the model we develop using the Takuchi method or the equation we develop using the Takuchi method will not have any cross product in the model. The first step is to understand the procedures involved in the process. As you can see here, the steps are start with selecting the problem and then objectives. Once you're done with those two things, then we have to make the selection of input and output variables and their corresponding levels. And then using the information, the orthogonal array selection will be done and the data will be collected from the real-time experiments. Similarly, we will analyze the data and construct the optimum model. So finally, once everything is done, the identified optimal conditions will be tested with one more random experiment or sometimes many experiments for estimating the prediction error. If everything goes well, then the optimum model will be finalized and used for the future predictions. Now let's move on to the next topic. The next topic is about signal to noise ratio, because it will help us to fix the problem objective. The ratio will help us to define the conditions, such as whether our objective is larger the better or nominal the best or smaller the better. Using these three conditions, we can easily fix our goal and we can solve the problem in a straightforward manner. In upcoming slides, we will learn them in a detail, like in which application we are gonna use this method and what is the target on the selected application, and then we will see either the optimization is about minimization or maximization, or we are gonna set the target value. As you can see in this slide, we will model the optimization problem for single point incremental sheet forming process. At first, let's see what is incremental sheet forming process. In this technique, what we do, we design a toolpath and we use them to make a small step-by-step localized incremental deformation on the sheet metal just by using the one hemispherical forming tool. Here, if you see the animation, you can easily understand how the process is done. In this design problem, our main aim is to minimize the surface roughness so that the parts manufactured by this process will have a good surface quality in terms of look as well as a good surface finish. The design problem is made by considering 4 input factors and 4 level design. They are vertical step size, spindle speed, forming tool radius, and finally feed rate. A 4-level design means that each input factor will be divided into 4 values based on the upper and lower limit. For example, in spindle speed, the lower limit is 3000 rpm and the upper limit is 6000 rpm. So if we convert them into 4-level design, it will be 3000 rpm in level 1 and 4000 rpm in level 2 and 5000 rpm in level 3 and finally 6000 rpm in level 4. If you see the animation, you can easily understand. I hope now it's clear for you to understand how we split the design levels. You just follow the same steps and divide the 4 values and 4 levels for other factors also. Now let's open the STAD tab, then select the DOE tab, followed by the Takuchi tab, and go for Create Takuchi Design option. Now the type of designs is available to us. As we discussed before, our design conditions are 4 factors and 4 level design. So select the third option and number of factors. Then finally you just choose the display available designs tab. As you can see here, under 4 level design, L16 design is available. Here 2 to 5 means the minimum and maximum factors limit. In detail, we can use this design if our design has a minimum of 2 input factor or maximum of 5 input factors or in between. Now select 2 to 5 tab and click OK. Then open designs tab. L16 design is available. Now to choose and snap OK. Similarly, open factors tab. As you can see, level values are in coded values. Now convert them into uncoded values just by putting them the input factor levels. I hope you remember what we did in the spindle speed factor, and you just follow the same procedure and split them into 4 level design and you just input them. Note that you can also keep them as a coded values and nothing to worry about that, and the results will be same, and you have to keep in mind that whether you are using coded levels or uncoded levels. Now then open options tab and make sure that you just click the store design in worksheet. So finally, we got the experimental design based on 16 possible combinations. As you can see here, based on the number of input factors and chosen levels, the experiment design is constructed from Takeuchi L16 orthogonal array. Based on the experimental design, we have to conduct 16 experiments, and sometimes we have to repeat the experiment if something goes wrong, but not necessary. Once the experiments are done, we have to measure the surface roughness and place them into the experimental design value. As you can see, eventually we got the surface roughness values from the experiment. Now we will again open the Minitab software and construct the Takeuchi design problem. Now similarly, open stat tab and go to DOE option. From there you can select again Takeuchi tab option. From there, you have to select Analyze Takeuchi Design. Once you choose the option, you will get Analyze Takeuchi Design tab. Our response is Surface Roughness, so choose Roughness and select. Then, you select Graphs option. From there, you make sure that you selected Signal to Noise Ratio and Means. Now you go to Analysis options. From here, you will get the response table for Signal to Noise Ratio as well as Mean. In case if you want to get the linear model, you can also select SN ratio as well as mean and simply click OK. And then go to the terms option. You have to make sure that you got only main terms and there should be no interaction terms. Finally, go to the graphs. Here you have to select 4 in 1. You will get all the graphs in one single plot. And finally, you select what is our objective here. Our objective is based on smaller is better. So for that, we have to select the option which says smaller is better and select that one and click OK. Once you are done, you can go to storage and you can see what kind of data you want to store in the worksheet. And if you don't want to save any data, it's OK. You just simply select OK. Now you are done with the Takeuchi design and you can see your final results here. Now you can see your main effects plot for means as well as SN ratio. As I said before, we got all our four graphs in a single plot. These graphs will help you to understand how good your model is. From main effects plot, we can easily say what parameter at what level it influences the surface roughness, which means we have to select the higher SN ratio so that we will get the minimum surface roughness. In our case, we have a 4 input parameter, so we have to investigate all the 4 input parameter and look for higher SN ratio at each level and select those corresponding level and use them to get the optimum model. Now we got all the results from the Takeuchi design. Now we have to understand what kind of data we got and we have to investigate them so that we can choose which parameter at what level we got the minimum surface roughness value. We need mainly the response table for signal to noise ratio where we can get all the information about the input parameter. The table will help us to identify which parameter influences the response most. But here if you see, the rank 1 stands for step size, which clearly states that step size influences the response at most. Similarly, if you see ANOVA table, from there we can understand whether all the 4 input parameter influence the response or not. For example, we have to check the p-value. From p-value, we can see which parameter is significant and which parameter is not significant. Significant means the parameter will impact the response. That means if you alter the parameter, it might have some influence on the response. It might improve the response or it might reduce the response. Non-significant means the parameter does not affect the response. Even if you alter the value, it does not give any impact on the response. So it is better to omit the parameter rather than keeping them in the model. For easy understanding, I copy all the data and I put it at one place so that we can discuss in an easy manner. As you can see in the slide, the table shows we conducted 16 experiments for 4 input parameter and we got roughness as our response and we also calculated the SN ratio from the Minitab software. Now, let's look into the response table so that we can understand which parameter influences the response at most. So now we have to find out which parameter has a higher SN ratio at what level. So if you closely investigate the SN ratio table at the right hand side, you can see the parameter A got the higher SN ratio at level 3. The parameters B and C got the higher SN ratio at level 1. But if you look into the parameter D, we got the higher SN ratio at level 4. So those are the optimum levels we are looking for. Now let's move on to the ANOVA table. From there we can see which input parameter is significant and which parameter is not significant. If you see the p-value, the parameters A, C, D and they are found to be significant, which means the tool radius and vertical step size and feed rate, and they are found to be impact the response, whereas the parameter B is insignificant, which means the spindle speed does not have any effect on the surface roughness, which clearly states that we can easily omit the spindle speed and we can use other three parameters to construct the optimum model. As you can see the main effects plot, you can clearly understand at what level each input parameter gives the good surface roughness value. For example, if you see the tool radius at level 3, we got the higher SN ratio. For spindle speed we got at level 1, similarly for step size also we got the higher SN ratio at level 1, and finally for feed rate we got higher SN ratio at level 4. Using this information, now we can get the final optimum combination, and based on that we will minimize our response. So now let's do some calculation so that you can understand how we are going to get the optimum model. The first step, we have to make average of all the data. So now we got a 16 sample and let's make average of all the 16 data. So now we are done. Now let's move on to the next calculation. It is also very similar to the previous step. We have to make an average of experimental data, but not the whole data. Let's see how. We already got the optimal conditions, right? Now we have to see our optimal conditions and we have to make an average data. For parameter A, we got an optimum value at level 3. So we have to select the level 3 responses and we have to make average of them. Similarly, we have to see the parameters B and C and we have to select the optimum levels 1 and we have to select the corresponding response data and we have to make an average. And finally, for parameter D, we have to select the level 4 and their corresponding response values and we have to make an average of all the data. And finally, we can use all this data to make an optimum model. Now we got all the data which we need. Let's substitute all the value into the final equation and find out what is our final surface roughness value, which means our optimized value. After calculation, we can see that our final optimum value is 0.2058 micrometer. So this is our final roughness value based on the Takuchi design. Now we have to verify the optimized model compared with the experimental data. For that, what I have did, I have conducted one more experiment using the optimal conditions I have got from the Takuchi design. And finally, from the measurement I got 0.202 micrometer as a surface roughness value, and when I made a prediction error calculation, I found out that it was above 2%. So finally, we can say that the Takuchi design works fine for our problem and we can use them to minimize the surface roughness. And you can also use for your own problem, but follow the same procedures if your problem is about to minimization. And I will make some more tutorial about considering the maximization. Also, I will make some tutorial about fixing the target value so that you can understand more about the Takuchi design. Thank you guys. See you in my next video.